got another bar. Let me grab it.
Okay, I take it up real quick.
That's a heavy load right there. That's why you want to get 4x4 Cummins pickup trucks. No, I'm just kidding. So we got 100 more boards of the tongue and groove from Windsor One, and we're going to be installing these in the master bedroom and master bathroom today. We're going to blind nail it, so yeah. This is the ceiling we're gonna start with. It's a simple vault ceiling, vaulted on both sides. It meets up at a ridge where it peaks out, and then it starts down here at the plumb wall. We're gonna be using this. This is an 18 gauge brad nailer, and I did not think this was sufficient for installing a 3/4 inch board overhead. So that's why I chose to face nail my previous tongue and groove in the last couple videos. But you guys were saying it worked, so I'm gonna give it a shot, and if it falls down, I'm gonna be pretty upset with you guys, so let's hope it doesn't. No, it should be fine. These boards are actually really lightweight. It's not like we're putting a big chunk of lumber up there or something. We'll give it a shot though. I'm always willing to try new things. And the first thing I need to do to get this job started is figure out that angle where that plumb wall meets that vault. Just push this up against the wall so both arms are just straight with each wall, and then we'll pull it down and it's going to give us 43. This thing counts in twos and it's right between 42 and 44. We could just rip this board at 45. It's not going to matter, because what that's going to allow us to do is have that edge of that taper on that cut just hug tighter to the wall, and we actually want that. What's cool about the Franklin sensor is it's gonna illuminate a light, three lights actually, and when you see those three lights, you know that your framing is in the middle. So you can just put a line or a crow's foot right there, whatever you wanna call it, and then just keep moving. Then we have our three lights illuminated again, and that is the quickest center finding stud finder I've ever seen. So three lights, mark the middle one, and then just keep moving. All right, pull it tight, pop the line, and hold your breath, because I put way too much chalk in this one. All right, so I got the cut hub set up right here with the extra long out feed, pretty cool. So we should be able to get a nice accurate rip down on these pieces right here. I don't know, guys, these 18 gauge blind nails are a little weak. No, I'm just kidding. They actually seem pretty stout. And since the nail is here, it's hidden. So that's the whole idea of the blind nail. The only face nail we should have is down here where we nailed into that top plate, and somewhere near the ridge up there. We'll probably do some more face nails. But we got a nice tight edge here against the wall with our board ripped down. So that'll be easy to caulk. And from here on out, we'll just start stacking these things up. We'll go with this one at 125 3/4 as well. A little bit of a pinch fit there, but that's actually preferred. Flooring mallet for the finish. Let's do one, yeah. They said one, so we'll go with what they said. Yeah, straight cut. So what we're doing with this little piece is we're just checking, this is just a square cut piece, we're just checking the ends. If it has a taper to the ceiling, you want to catch that early on because you'll end up with a bunch of pieces that would need an angled adjustment on each end. But we're looking straight so far, so we're gonna keep going. Let's go ahead and pull this masking from the drywall, guys. So we'll get this one in position. We'll get it tapped down where it needs to go, and we'll reach our hand back there, trace the circle out, and take it back off and cut it. I'm gonna go ahead and throw my glasses on for this next thing I'm gonna show you, because I don't wanna get hit in the eye with one of these nails. But I wanna show you how this looks out here in the open when you're blind nailing this stuff. So what it is you got this tongue right here, part of this tongue and groove board, and you're shooting kind of in this little valley right here. Not really right through the tongue, but kind of in this little dip. So that's what we've been doing at least, and we've been angling the nails like this. So when they come out of the backside and they go in through the drywall and hit the joist, they're at this angle. You can see we got quite a bit of a nail there that's gonna go into the framing. And then the tongue is not obstructed by any nail. Now, when we first started this earlier on, what I did was shot it a little too much straight up, not at an angle. And when we went to put the next piece on, it wasn't allowing it to sit flush. So you definitely have to do it at an angle like this. And especially with these Windsor One tongue and groove boards, they're milled perfectly. And you want to see that perfect chamfer to chamfer edge come together to create that V shape there. So these things are just absolutely beautiful when they come together. But that's what we've been doing, and it's been working out for us. So I gotta admit it, I was wrong. There's nothing else to say. You should definitely not be face nailing this stuff. Everything else I said in that last video about, you know, installing and all that, I still stand behind that, but I'm a believer now in this 18 gauge blind nailing. The boards are lightweight. These Radiata Pine boards from Windsor One, at least the ones we're using. I know there's other tongue and groove boards that are quite a bit heavier, But I just can't recommend these Windsor ones enough. And funny story, when we were bringing this stuff in the other day, the builder saw these. He saw us unloading them, and he was like, "Are those primed on both sides?" And I was like, "Yes, sir, they are." He's like, "Can you do the porch lids for me too? Give me a quote on that, because we need to get that done." So pretty cool. These materials actually earned me another job, just because a builder who knew what he was looking at, he knows, hey, these are protected, that not only are they treated, but they're primed on both sides. They're gonna avoid moisture, so it's gonna avoid a ton of problems from him down the road from whichever homeowner he uses them on. I'll finish up showing you guys the blind nails that I'm gonna finish shooting on this board here. And the Milwaukee nailer actually has a cool feature built in. It kind of doubles as a little mallet on the back with this rubber back on it. So I'll just tap that down a little bit. I got a joist over there in the corner always, and then we'll blind nail through there. So I'm pointing, if I was gonna shoot through the tongue, I'd be more up like that. So I'm gonna shoot more at an angle like that, down in that little dip right there. We're getting a nice grab there, and that one's already shot. So now when I come to bring this down where I shot that nail, you can see perfection right there. So pretty cool, no obstructions in the way. And like I said, super crisp joint right there. So yeah, keep correcting me in the comments. I don't know half of everything. I don't know a quarter of everything. And it's funny, it's ironic, I've learned more doing this YouTube channel than I could ever teach. And it's a very, very unique experience, because I'm putting my stuff out there. People are saying, hey, you should do this, or hey, try this tool. I mean, most of these tools that I'm wearing in this Diamondback tool belt, I didn't find on my own. I mean, it's pretty crazy. So a lot of things that kind of changed the way I do things came from YouTube comments. So it's very, very interesting. We're gonna keep going up the ceiling here. It's gonna be the same process. I won't bore you guys with it. We're gonna do the same thing on this wall. It's gonna be the same exact process. Thank you so much for watching this video. I probably will do some Milwaukee hoodies and definitely some more Milwaukee shirts. If you would wear a hoodie, let me know in the comments, because I gotta make these things, get them made, and then buy them and kind of know. So I kind of want to gauge, if I buy like 200 hoodies, am I gonna just be stuck with 200? Like, I get 100, John gets 100, or will people actually buy them? So let me know if that sounds cool. And other than that, thanks for hanging out with us again on this video as we progress here at this job, and we'll see you next time.